everyone, and welcome to the Run to Win show, where we bring to you inspiring stories, experiences, information and trivia from interesting people who are a part of the running world. I am your host Vinny Ajmera, and on today's episode we are talking to half marathoner Bharat Kapadia. Bharat has run almost 24 half marathons since 2007 and is still going strong. He is the founder of ideas@bharatkapadia.com, and no, it's not an email ID, it is the name of his company, which in itself sounds like an idea. His career spans across several media houses in leadership roles, and he has won a number of media awards. He spearheaded the Vote for Taj campaign, which resulted in the Taj Mahal, making it to the new 7 Wonders of the World list. I met Bharat when I first started running, as we trained together with the same group. Eventually, I moved on to a different location and group, but we still keep running into each other on our Sunday runs. He's charming and infectiously positive, as you're about to discover, and we fondly call him Bharat Bhai. I had so much fun catching up with him again. We discussed about what keeps him going, how he has managed to run better every passing year, and his role in making the Juhu Marathon happen. I hope you enjoy our conversation, and if you do, I would love it if you would subscribe to the Run to Win show and leave a rating and review on iTunes so more people can find the show. Without further ado, let's get started. Welcome to this episode on Run to Win. I'm delighted to also have Bharat Kapadia with me here today, and I'm excited to chat with you, Bharat Bhai. Welcome on my show today.
It's so nice to be with you, Vinny, after such a long time, and nice to see you sitting here, because we have always been running together.
Indeed. Yes. In fact, it's very interesting to see you in gear which is outside of running.
Yes, yes. Otherwise, we always in shorts. Some people don't even recognize me in full pants.
Obviously, shift the context and see people and recognize them. But before we jump in, we do a form of warm-up like we do in our runs.
Yes,
also.
It is a must.
So tell us who you are, where you're from, and what you do.
You've already given my name and what people call me, Bharat Bhai. Everybody calls me Bharat Bhai except my wife.
Thank God for that.
Yeah. And I am from Bombay, always a Mumbaikar. And I have been in media for all my professional career. And I have both the content side and the managerial side, both I have managed. And I was part of many big publishing houses.
For those of you who don't know Bharat Bhai, I must say he's one of the wittiest people I know. He can bring up a witty one-liner from just about any context. And I think
fun. No, my first office was in witty.
Okay.
So that's where the wittiness comes from.
Oh my God. I think that's another one. I think that's brilliant, and I'm hoping we're going to have a lot more of these in the course of our conversation.
Let's go, run with it.
Tell me, what got you started? How did you decide to start running?
Oh, you won't believe it, because I was a non-runner, completely a non-runner. I had never run half a kilometer in my life. And I used to go, just for fitness sake, I used to go to Talwarkas just to do a little bit of exercises, freehand exercises and all. And suddenly one fine morning I found a notice board over there. They said that we are official training partners for Mumbai Marathon. And we can train you for 21 kilometers and 42 kilometers. And I thought to myself, who can actually run 21 kilometers? And I asked my fellow members over there. I said, are they mad? 21 kilometers? Kone kevai? In
so
Gujarat.
When was this? Which year was this?
This was in 2007.
Okay.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
And they've taken 3 years contract for training marathoners. And I said, what are you going to give in training? How can somebody who is not a runner, how can he start running? What are you going to train? What is there to train in running? You just go and run. No, so then they explained that, you know, it's a proper training. You will actually have to build up your endurance, etc. and all that. And then I started with no intention of doing 21 kilometers, but I registered for 21 for training. And I thought that if I take training for 21, I'll be able to at least run 5 kilometers nonstop. That will be some achievement in my life.
But so then what triggered you to take it up? Because of course, you know, there are so many things that gyms run. And was there a moment where you felt, or was there a thought that came in your mind?
No. I was a reluctant runner. Actually, nothing inspired me. In fact, I was trying to get away from it once having decided the dialogue I started that I want to get trained. But I said, okay, let me see if I can run 5 kilometers after taking the training, and I plunged into it.
Okay. And so who and what supported this initial aspiration, however reluctant it was?
Nobody supported me. Everybody laughed at me that, are you going to run? Really? And I also saw, when I stood in front of the mirror, I also asked the same question to me, really? And then we started training, and I actually had made up my mind that I'll run only 5 kilometers. But since I had registered for 21, I took the training seriously. Before that, I went to a friend of mine who is an ortho, and I said I must take his advice. So when I went to him, he first asked me that, how old are you? So I said, I am 54. He says, 54? After 50, you don't do all these stunts. So I said, sir, Mr. Doctor, my friend, before 50, whatever stunts one can do, I have already done. I need something new. So he said, all right, if you want, it is not a strict no medically, but you can try it out. And you take training and your body will tell you whether you can run or not. So I started training because I had already paid money for training. Not to run, but just to train.
So the commitment was having registered, yeah. Like paid for the training.
And one good thing about this is you have to get up early and run, because before the sun comes out, the weather is nice to run and it is cooler comparatively. So you have to get up early. And I have no problems in getting up early.
And what's really interesting is your doctor friend said after 50, don't experiment too much. But it's interesting to see how the narrative has changed today.
Yeah.
When you said from 2007 to now, where 54 is
this is
really a big deal anymore.
Yeah, that's true. And as they say that, you know, new, young and new, old, the definitions are changing because people are into fitness. The awareness has increased. People want to really be fit. So that is a good sign. And because when I started, there were fewer runners. Now, I think last year, Mumbai Marathon had nearly 50,000 runners.
Yeah, it's brilliant. Close to. It's picked up some tremendous pace. And
there used to be only two or three big events in a year. Now you see it every week, something or the other is happening. Some weeks there are more than one races.
That is so true. I mean, to see how running has seeped into normal people's lives as well.
That's right.
As opposed to maybe some years ago, if we saw people running, we think they are idiots in Bombay at least.
Yes, yes.
We'd be like, I think 15, 20 years ago, if I had to see someone running on the road, we'd think it's really silly.
Yeah, yeah. Either you admire them as gods or you ridicule them as jokers.
Yes, I mean, who does
extreme.
That? Who runs
yeah.
on the roads?
Correct.
And so a lot has changed since.
Yes,
and
aren't we glad about it?
Of course. So tell me, what has your journey been like till today from that first day that you started? And what all have you truly experienced even in pure play running?
So as I told you that I was a reluctant runner. I just took training just for fun and wanted to do just 5 kilometers. But on the race day, something told me from inside that you have to complete 21. So not the previous day, but on the race day in the morning, when I was on the starting line, I said, I must finish 21. And I'll run half and I'll walk half, but I will complete 21 somehow. And that was my mindset that time. And that time the Mumbai Marathon used to start from VT and it used to come up to Worli and then we had to take a U-turn. So I said, I'll run and then I will walk.
And so that's around 10 and a half.
Yeah, 10 and a half one way. So it is exactly half. So I started running and when I came to Mela, I said to myself, I'm not that tired. Let me continue. And I continued and I could do Ajili and I could do also the Pedder Road Bridge. Once you did that, then when I came to Babulnath, it was only 3 kilometers left. And I saw some fellow runner who was sitting down on the pavement. I stopped and encouraged, not worrying about my timing. I didn't even know that, you know, timing is important. So I just encouraged them and then we finished it. But when I finished 21 kilometers after crossing the finishing line, I actually looked back that really, is it me who ran? I couldn't believe myself. And I was so happy that I even asked the volunteer that time they had flagged off Dream Run from the opposite side of the road. I said, can I join them? And she said, no, you can't because you have a different bib. You cannot. So that kind of enthusiasm I created within myself and it has been a very good journey.
So you said you saw a fellow runner who was sitting down and you encouraged him. And of course, I've known you for 5 years plus now. And, you know, we've been running together at the beach. That's one quality of yours which consistently stands out. So we all may have our good days of motivating people, but you never cease to do that. Like, even if I'm struggling running, suddenly I'll see bright and sparkly face coming towards me and always saying hi. Like, so is that where that first race where your whole ability and drive to motivate others started?
No, I believe that if I can do it, why can't anybody else do? So, and I started at 54, as I said. I believe that, you know, you have to lead by example. And sometimes people need a little trigger or sometimes little encouragement. Because when they think that they can't do it or they are tired and all that, one nice smile or one nice word will actually recharge their batteries and they can do it. Actually, running you have to do on your own. Nobody can run for you. So you have to, what else can I do? I can encourage them while running, or before or after also we can discuss our experiences and we can share that what are do's and don'ts of good run and all that. So, and I tell everybody whom I, want to encourage to run, that in running, timing is not important as everybody makes it out to be. It should be fun running. You should enjoy it. Second thing is you should complete the race, whatever you have undertaken. And third, it should be you should try to make it injury free. Yes. So for that, you have to prepare yourself. So if you prepare yourself, you can't just get up one fine morning and start running half a marathon. You cannot do that. You have to build your endurance. You have to train yourself and do it. And once you do it, you'll start enjoying.
Which brings me back to my next question, where you said that when you came to Mela, which was the halfway point, you felt you weren't that tired and you carried on. So how many kilometers maximum had you run before the actual race?
We had done about, I think, 15 kilometers. Okay. And I had done it very reluctantly because mujhe kahan karna hai pura 21. So I was taking it very easy. But I could build up, I could see that, you know, from a non-runner, I had never run half a kilometer in my life before. So to take training and start running little bit, and I could see that I can run 5 and 10 kilometers was encouraging enough for me and self-motivating.
And how long was your training for a first-time runner? Would that have been at least?
I had a business trip before Diwali, and as you know, that Mumbai Marathon is always third Sunday of January. I had only 45 days of training.
Wow, that's really narrow.
And as I said, I had not run even half a kilometer in my life before.
So how possible was that? Did it not seem difficult?
No, something inside told me that, you know, if you attempt, you can do it. And that has been my motivating, inspirational within. And that I pass it on to others. And I ask point blank everybody, what is your excuse? If I can run, why can't you run?
Lovely. So, and then after that, what has been your journey like?
So that was about today? 11 years back. This January will be my 12th consecutive Mumbai Marathon. What I tried to do was that, you know, every year I tried to compete with myself and improve my timing, which I was able to do it for 9 continuous years. So from first time about 2 hours and 40 minutes, I came down to my best has been 2:11.
Well, that's really fantastic because it's not always possible, as I discovered through my running journey.
Yeah.
That I did do consecutive improvements. So I went from 2:30 to 2:27 to 2:24 and then my personal best at 2:23. And then it was only a downslide thereafter. So how did you manage that and what keeps you improving each time? What is it that you do specifically?
So you learn your mistakes and you learn what is your peak and what is how you do it. And initially you try to compare yourself with your fellow runners. But that is the mistake you should not do. You are competing with yourself because each human being is different. Your body genetics are different from theirs. Your food habits, your party habits, your friends, everything is different. So how can you expect what worked for him will work for me, or what didn't work for her will not work for me? That's not the issue. You have to find your own, the best thing which you can do. So I try to, you experiment with your diet, you experiment with your sleeping pattern, And you try to see where you are getting more tired or you are not getting more tired despite running faster or whatever. All these things. And then there are trainers. You ask trainers, then you ask your experts, those who have run better. And you see that whether that fits into your scheme of things. Right. Then you can always do better.
Yes.
Okay. So, and how positively has it influenced any of these fears?
So, as I kept on running for years and I crossed 60 when the people, they said that you have now become a senior citizen and this and that. I used to jokingly tell them that when I register for marathon, they send me a walking stick along with my registration bib. So, but I thought that, you know, even after crossing 60, I could improve my timing. So why can't other people do it? So I was seeing, and I used to go to gym for also my other training and all that. I could see that so many people were interested in running, but they didn't know how to go about it. And they thought that, you know, some people can run, some people can't run. So when I asked them, they used to come to me and say that we want to run. What can we do? We can only walk. We can't run. I said, everybody can walk. What's new in it? But if you run, it will be much better and more gratifying and satisfying to you. So try running. And then there are do's and don'ts, as you know, that you have to, just running is not you one fine morning get up and start running. You have to warm up before the run. Then you run properly, build your endurance. And then after the run, it is very important to stretch. And your body doesn't know what you are trying to do in a long distance running. So body tries to protect you by secreting lactic acid in your system, which hardens the muscles. So if you don't do anything about it, you don't stretch, that acid will remain in your body and it will harden the muscle. In 2 days, you will say that it is not my cup of tea because my muscles are very sore and I can't run. If you do this stretching and all that, your muscles will get relaxed and you will be able to run again. So every day if you run like this, or every alternate day you run like this, your body will also start understanding that this fellow is not going to give up. So better be accustomed to his style of running. Then it happens. Your body adjusts.
Okay. And then, so then did you put that across to the Juhu?
Yeah. So what we did was we tried through a club. We had a small event where we had 1500 participants.
Fantastic. And for the first event.
For the first event. Okay. And they all enjoyed. And I was very glad that I could make about 50 people who said we can never run. I made them join and trained them and they started running. All of them are now doing 10 and 21 kilometers very easily. So I could see that, you know, a little bit of training and giving guidance helps everybody. So we started this organization called Get Fit Through Sports Foundation.
Okay.
In short, we call it Get Fit. So for fitness, people think only two things in mind, either dieting or the gym. And we said, no, if you pursue any sport seriously, if you know the do's and don'ts about it and you pursue it seriously, you will be fit. So that's how Get Fit started this. And 2 years back, we started Juhu Half Marathon. And both years we have associated with Rotary Club and jointly we have conducted Juhu Half Marathon.
Well, it was very well organized because I ran one too.
Yeah,
and
you
I think
ran,
it was brilliant.
Yes.
It was lot of fun.
So first time we got about 3,000 runners. Last year we had about 4,000 runners.
Yes, I think that's the one.
And this year we are expecting to cross 5,000 runners.
And I'm definitely going to be one of those.
Yes, and I want to see you on podium.
Oh my God, that is just a very far cry.
Yeah, you can do it.
You'll
you
have to
runner.
Secretly put me in a different age category.
No,
then,
that,
like
that I can't do. I can't lie about your age, that you are 50 and you are just 16 and 17. So how can
this
I?
This is true. When you talk about Get Fit Through Sports, is it, what all are you doing with it? Just the Juhu Marathon, what do you do about it? Or are there other things also that you are right now working on with the NGO?
Okay, Get Fit Through Sports Foundation is an NGO. What we do is actually encourage people to take up any sports. First, because I love running, we started with the running event. And we have been doing it for the last 2 years. And next February 10th, we are going to have the third round. And when we expect 5,000 runners to run. Luckily, we have Hrithik Roshan and those.
Yeah, tell us about that. How could you get, like, I mean, Hrithik Roshan is a superstar and for him to endorse the marathon.
There are two things, because he had two things to share with us. The love for Juhu and love for running, Juhu Beach. So he had these two things which actually worked out well for us, and he encouraged us and he became our brand ambassador. Not only that, his HRX brand, he gave free t-shirts to all the participants.
And I loved that color when I ran. I loved that, those t-shirts.
It's a very high quality, very good top of the line t-shirt. So that is how we got involved, and we are very happy about his participation into this. So that is worked out, and now we will gradually we'll have to create funds for what we want to do to people to get into sports. We have to train them, we have to guide them, we have to give them medical and other advice, and all that we'll have to set it up, and we'll take up other sports also.
So what's the next sport on your wish list?
That we have not yet finalized, but there are so many sports people can take. For example, cycling, swimming, skating, and other, so many things are there, which doesn't require too much of, equipments and all that. Like running, the whole world is your gym.
Right.
And you can run any time of the day. So you start running that, so you don't need much of this thing. So it is like that, very simple things you can do and take it up.
And the other thing is, for those who may want to support you or who may want to be a part of your NGO, because it does sound like fun, it does sound like a great thing to do, and sport is something that's picking up a lot, even in Mumbai and in this city. Where could they find Get Fit through sports?
See, there are three ways one can be associated with Get Fit activity. One is that you participate in the event. That is a very big thing.
Okay.
So as a runner, you can do just now.
So I'm already participating.
Yeah. Second thing is that you can sponsor. So your company or your corporates or anybody, you can also sponsor. And sponsorship can be in cash or kind. So cash sponsorship is they give money, big sponsors. And in kind, people give like water or they give energy drink, which is required and all that. And third thing is you can be part of the organizing committee or committee volunteers. So you can be either any one of these three things you can do. And Get Fit is an NGO. We don't have a office. We operate out of our director's places and all that. So there is Atul Parekh and Jayesh Choksi and Dilip Kathrani and myself, and we are some of us, Sandeep Tarkas is there. So we are all experienced in different fields, and we put our experience also to organize this well. And I think it will grow as the time grows. We will be able to do much better things for people.
I also recall you telling me, and I think this is a very cute story because I relate to that whole part about winning this whole, or the innovation part, that you really particularly like innovating. And tell us about that whole newspaper innovation that you had come up with some time back.
See, having worked in media for many years, I thought that, I was a little bit of wasting time in doing drudgery, which I was not enjoying. So I thought that I should do what I like to do best, and I like to do things very differently and give good ideas and all that. So I started my company called Ideas at BharatKapadia.com. That is the name of my company. And first innovation I did was for...
So the name is Ideas. So it's not a domain. It's a name.
It is a domain. It is my URL and it is my name of my company. So that's also an idea.
Clearly.
Yeah. So the first innovation I thought was that something very unique to newspaper I should do, innovate. So I came up with an idea with a lot of experiments and all that. We came out with fragrant newspaper innovation. So the first time in the world, there was a smell of coffee coming out of newspaper.
And what triggered that idea? What was the purpose of creating this?
Because I was associated with newspaper, I thought that, a lot of revenue was going away to other media, like television and digital was also picking up. I said something very unique to newspaper, we should do it so that revenue can come. And I was holding a newspaper and I first thought that, newspaper is the only medium we are holding in your hand. So something to do with touch, to tactile, some innovation I should do it. And suddenly I got a smell of ink. So when I got the smell of ink, I thought that, this is a very strong idea. And you should create the smell in the newspaper. If the newspaper is giving fragrance of what the product you want to sell, it will be outstanding innovation, and it worked out very well.
I know, because coffee is like a morning thing for most people, and then newspaper is a morning thing for most people who believe in print newspaper.
Yes.
So I think that's
a
fantastic.
And the sense of smell is a very strong bond any animal can have. So it's like your infant recognize parents with the smell. They don't know your name. They only recognize you by smell. Or for that matter, a buffalo or a cow with the calf walking behind that mother, how do they identify the mother? Only through smell. So it's a very strong bonding which animal can have. And some of the smell like coffee and chocolate and all that can also create craving in you. And that's the purpose of advertising it.
Correct. But is there, are there certain publications using it? Or is
no,
there...
it can be done by anybody. So because we have perfected the technique and anybody can use it.
Okay.
So we give a turnkey solution for that also. And we can create any smell now.
Okay, brilliant, brilliant. So, of course, for those of us who want to pick up the newspaper tomorrow morning onwards, yes, we will definitely think about you.
Yes.
And see if we can spot the smell of coffee in there. You know, you said that you need to stretch, you need to do these things, you need to rest well. Tell me something more about that, because I've experienced this and I know other people may as well. But like you said, we all have different social life, different friends. How has running and the whole idea that you choose to run in the mornings, because where we are at Mumbai, the weather is far better in the mornings. So how have these early mornings impacted your social life? And is there a compromise you've needed to make to be able to run regularly?
If you are able to wake up early, your half battle is won. And we are lucky that we are near Juhu. So the Juhu beach, you know, running on the beach, on the soft sand, not soft sand, but on the middle bed, is very good for your knees. Because if you run on hard surface, your knees might also, because when you are training, your action and your posture and all that is not very good. So for training purpose, the sand is very good because it's softer on knees. And once you train on the beach, you can run much better on the road. So it is a good thing that, you know, we are lucky to have this kind of beach. We have so many beaches in Mumbai, and now they are cleaning up also very well. So it's good. And you can see so many people running. So the running tells you two, three things very, very different from others is, one, you get discipline. So when you get up early, as my elder brother used to say, when you get up early, you get a longer day than others. So you can do much more.
I believe in this too, completely. Yeah. Oh, it has helped me so much to accomplish.
So you get discipline. Secondly, when you start training yourself, you start believing in yourself. And third thing, when you achieve a milestone like half marathon or full marathon, whatever, you can then take up any challenge in life. Because if you, for many people, doing half marathon is an impossibility. And you can't do it. It is an achievement they see. But once you do it, it becomes so easy and then you are ready for the next challenge. You can take it up, not just running challenges. You can take up any challenge in your life.
Yes. And then how did you, were there any compromises that you needed to make then vis-a-vis people who don't know about running?
No. So the compromises are also your nightlife and social life gets disturbed, because if you have to get up early at 5 o'clock, 5:30 in the morning and start running, then you have to discipline yourself. You cannot have very heavy food, very late night and all that. Your stomach should be clean before you start running. Because in the middle of the run, where will you go? You will run faster probably, but where will you go is the problem.
I remember there was a very funny one-liner you had told me about running. You were telling me about your singing when you went for an event for singing, and I think you should share this with the audience.
You know, I am a singer by hobby, and sometimes I'm called in a very professional setup as a guest singer, and sometimes I'm introduced that he also runs marathon. So I said, not also runs marathon. To the audience, I make it very clear that, you know, why I took to run marathon, why I took training to run so much, because I sing. And if you don't like my singing, somebody may run after me. So if somebody runs after me from the audience, I will make him or she run for 21 kilometers. And I keep on running, and somebody can still follow up to 21 kilometers. I'll sing another song over there.
Another song over there. Fantastic. And that's how it is. But so when you keep training this regularly, is it hard on some days when you may feel low, or you may feel low on energy, or You may not be feeling up to it for whatever reason. So is it hard then to believe in this whole sport and the way you feel about running when others are running amazingly well and you're not having such a great run?
See, first of all, I don't compare myself to other runners because, as I said, the competition is with you, yourself. So you try to do your best. If somebody is not doing well, you don't become, it's like, you know, drawing your own line by, you can't cut somebody's line short and your line doesn't become bigger. So you have to find your own comfort zone and come out of it. So first of all, you have to see that, you know, what is making you run. There are some days that you don't want to get up and run. Those are the days I make it a point that I have to run.
What do you tell yourself?
Yes, when your mind says no, discipline means you have to do what you are supposed to do when your mind says no. And once you do that, that threshold level goes away and then you will, your mind will never say no. So that's
the reason. And what are the other thoughts? Like, what are the other motivators that keep you going when the mind is saying no?
Motivation is, of course, there are benefits of running. I have found that, you know, fitness is there. Once you are able to run long distance, your stamina throughout the days becomes very good. Your thoughts process becomes cleaner. You are able to ideate better and all that. What else do you need? The fitness is everything.
So when you say you're able to ideate better, have you got many of these insights or aha moments when you're running, when you're in the middle of the run and suddenly there is this whole light bulb that lights up?
Yes, yes. I run a consultancy on media and marketing and my company's name is ideas@bharatkapadia.com. So my job is to generate newer ideas. And ideas can come from anywhere. And it is not related to something that you don't take inspiration from cloud and start doing something or something. That idea can be triggered by anything. Because you are on the go, you are in the momentum, you are to yourself, nobody is bothering you. You can think a lot of things. And that is the best time to think and you can ideate and you can crystallize your thoughts.
And then how do you remember them? Because you're in the middle of your run. Because it's happened to me often and I've done something really funny about it because I have actually stopped strangers on the road because I don't carry a phone. So I've stopped strangers, I've borrowed their phone and I've recorded a voice note and sent a WhatsApp to myself because I feel, what if I forget this idea after another 5 kilometers? So how do you remember them or document them?
Good ideas you never forget. I'll tell you a very interesting story about Einstein. Einstein was talking to somebody, they were taking a walk in the park with some businessman, and Einstein being Einstein had so many thoughts and all that. So businessman told Einstein that, why don't you write it down? You will forget all this thing. He says, if you forget, then that is not a good idea.
I think that's a good thought. I can live with that.
Yeah. So if it is a good idea, it will haunt you. You don't have to record it. You don't have to worry about it.
So 2007 to now, you're going to be running the 12th year. And have you ever thought of dropping out?
Never, never. I look forward to more and more events. And of course, Mumbai Marathon has been my starting point, so I look forward to that. And luckily for me, I came fifth in my category in 2018. Thank you so much. I didn't expect myself to do that better, but it's not my speed. I think my age has given me that.
I also think it's your habit of winning awards in whatever you do. Because, for those who don't know, of course, you've received several accolades also at work.
Yeah, so. But I don't do it for awards. But if you do a good job, that's your reward. Absolutely. And reward is more important than award.
Well said. So how does your morning play out? How do you run out of the door? You know, what's your morning like in terms of how do you push yourself to get out? Do you eat something?
For my college life and my professional life, I have a habit that if I have to go somewhere early in the morning, I get up 1 hour before that. And that habit has helped me a lot because if I have to report at 6 o'clock to Juhu Beach, I get up at 5 o'clock, regardless of what. I stay at the Juhu Beach there and I can just walk on to the beach. But even then, I get up 1 hour early. And people say that, you know, you should not eat something and you should not eat this and I can't eat this and that. I find it very funny. I always have milk and some cereal, oat cereal, and I have it in the morning. Before the run.
Okay.
And I enjoy the run. I don't go empty stomach.
And what do you particularly look forward to when you're going for these runs?
Of course, the entire exercise of, you know, warming up and being with your friends and run. And because you don't know the schedule of the entire month or anything. The coach, Brinson Miranda, is a very good coach of BeFit.
Of course, we've trained with him together.
And I've been a founder member of BeFit, so I know that. And he tells us, because he reads your body and he gives you encouragement to do better and better. So every day there is a different challenge. Sometimes you have to do only drills, and sometimes, you know, he takes us to one place and makes us do drill.
Yes, I've also always enjoyed these drills, in fact, and I look forward to them on many days. What part of running or training do you enjoy most?
I actually enjoy everything. And actually, I find running a stress reliever instead of building stress, because you keep running, and if you enjoy running, you can enjoy the weather. You are, as I said, you are to yourself. You can start thinking whatever you want to. Nobody to disturb you. Nobody to tell you, take a left turn and right turn and do this, sit down and all that. You don't have to obey to anybody. You have to only obey to your own body and keep on running.
And what helps you run better?
I listen to music while running. And I also have an app on my mobile. So along with the music, it also prompts me every 5 minutes that I've covered so much distance in so much speed and all that. So I'm able to fine tune it. Not that it matters, but it is helping. So you can always fine tune your speed or whatever. If you are lagging behind or if you are doing better, then you are encouraged to do even more.
I think that's a really brilliant. I feel that also today when I sometimes talk to people and they've joined the same running group. Some people write to me and they say that, thanks so much, you inspired us to run. So sometimes even inspire without actually physically doing it.
Yeah, that's true. But sometimes, you know, people have the inertia which has to be broken.
Yes.
They are able to run. They should be able to run. But they said how to go about it, they don't know. Sometimes they feel that, no, that's not my cup of tea. So if I ask them, they want to run, but, you know, something is stopping them. So then I tell them jokingly that, you know, I have published a book on excuses. and that book does not have any text.
I think I should be the first one to buy it, because this inertia state sets into me after every Mumbai marathon. I'm off running and I have to restart the journey.
So I said there is no text in the book, so in the excuse book. So if you say that, you know, weather is bad today, it is raining. So I would say it's excuse number 37. What next?
Right.
Like that. So, you know, you eventually when you start running, you will realize that all the things which you think are a bad thing, not for allowing you to run, are very petty things, and you can overcome them very easily.
In fact, I remember you told me, talking of books, a very cute story about you and Scott Jurek, and you said he was here.
Scott Jurek, everybody knows that he's an ultra marathoner, and he is a 7-time world record winner. He had done, he had come here to release his book called Eat and Run. He had turned into vegan and he didn't eat non-veg and all that. So he had to discover his own recipes to get a lot of carbs and protein balance in his food. So he became a chef by himself and he has written a book. But he had come here and his previous record that time was that he had run 165.5 miles. In 24 hours. So as people say, you know, elderly people say, everybody has got 24 hours. What can you do about it? So just see, once somebody runs, this is about 250 kilometers in a day.
So then what happened with Scott Jurek?
So he had come here to release his book and he also cooked for us and we ate his food. Then the next morning we had a 10 kilometer demo run on the Juhu Beach. So we were about 20 of us and he was also showing. While running, he was correcting some people's postures. After we finished and we sat down, and I said, Jurek, did you notice two things? So he said, what? I said, you may be world champion, but I was running ahead of you. So naturally, he was guiding everybody, so he can't be in front. And I said, more people waved at me than you. He said, nobody knows you here except 20 of us. And so many people waved at me. So he said, yeah, I could see that. I said, I'm world famous in Juhu Beach. But then I said, no, I was just waving at them because I need my hands also to be exercised.
How has running influenced or impacted different areas of your life? So whether it's social, mental, emotional, professional, has it had any influence on it? And how have these aspects of your life influenced running for you?
Yes, running definitely has impacted a lot of things because, as I said, you can't have late nights. You can't have so heavy food on the previous night of even your training days, leave aside only race days. So it definitely changes the pattern of your social life. And then sometimes some people, your old friends and all that, give up on you sometimes, but they are very proud of your achievement. So then they come back. And then they adjust.
And do they get irritated given all of us runners have one habit? We can talk about running endlessly.
Yeah, it is a running commentary. I said, you know, once you are able to cross some milestone, which is seemingly impossible for many and for you, once you have done that, you can take up any challenge in life. You can do so many things which you formerly thought that you can't do it, can't attempt it, it's not my cup of tea, but you can do it and probably will come out a winner there also.
And how have these fears influenced running?
This long distance running tells you to come out of your comfort zone. So it is, Sunday morning, the races are there, people are sleeping, half the city, half the world is sleeping. You get up at 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock and go and run. So you think that, you are able to do so much better. And that encourages you to try out newer things. You can do a lot of things and your stamina increases. Your mind is fresh and you can do a lot of things during the day.
What would you like to tell someone who is on the fence about running?
See, there cannot be anybody on fence. Either you fantasize about running or you actually run.
Okay.
So you, if you are thinking of running, just take proper training, because one fine morning you just can't get up and start running long distance. So you have to train yourself, your body has to be trained, you have to create endurance in your body, and you have to create power for running at a good speed and continuously. You have to also know the discipline of hydrating yourself, and how do you eat, what do you eat, how much you drink, what do you drink is also important. So
you had said there is only one impact you can have on non-runners when I asked you. So what is that impact? Share it with everyone else.
You see, once you start running, then you will believe in yourself. And I tell everybody that don't say that I cannot run. If you are a non-runner, N-O-N, non-runner, you train yourself and you'll suddenly become a non-runner.
Oh God, that's another one of Bharat Bhai's one-liners. Yes. From a non-runner to a known runner.
Correct.
Brilliant.
Correct.
Great. So we're going to move on now to the next segment. And this is a fun one. And I call it sprint because it is like a very quick one word or one-line answers. Share one running inspiration that comes to your mind now.
Running itself is given a lot of benefits. So running itself is a motivation.
What kind of runners do you run away from?
I don't like people who grudge and they talk too much and they say this is hurting and that is hurting. And I didn't get up early and I came late. And all those crying babies I don't like. And I run faster because if they come near to me, it is actually helping me.
What is the one running gear that you won't step out of your house?
My mobile, because I need to listen to my music and to my timing, which is from the
one must run event.
Is of course Mumbai Marathon. Mumbai Marathon has been a milestone because I started my journey from there and I have improved and I could come in first five in the race. So this is a good thing. And Mumbai Marathon also allows you to run on sea link.
Yes, the entire coast, in fact, coastline.
That early morning when sun is rising, it's such a beautiful sight to see thousands of runners running beside you. And it's a really a good experience.
If not running, then what sport?
Then sports. Sports, I like indoor sports. I love chess. But for me, if I'm not running, I'm into music. So I keep singing or listening to music.
So I'd like your take on communication, authenticity and resilience, the car that I had discovered, on how that has influenced running for you in either getting better or how has that helped you with running? And how has running helped you in getting better at communication, authenticity and resilience?
See, once you start running and believing in yourself, you start communicating with yourself. your body, your mind. So that's the best communication one can have. And once you start achieving something, some milestones, then you are able to communicate this to other people much better. So that skill develops automatically because you have something to say which people are ready to listen to.
Absolutely.
Yeah. And of course, authenticity, because if you have run, then only you lead by example. You can't sit in an air-conditioned cabin and not run even two. You can't even say that you run 21 kilometers and you don't take two steps to even walk. Then nobody will believe you.
That's true.
So that's true. And if you consistently do what you are doing and trying to do better and better than yourself, competing with yourself, then that is how your car is built.
Absolutely.
And you don't need a car for running.
So I need you to now just imagine that you have run your last race ever. Mm-hmm. And now you have finished it in the way that you have always wanted. It's a podium finish. Mm. And you're on the stage of the Mumbai Marathon, the largest ever constructed and built. And there are thousands and lakhs of people who are out there. They're cheering for you right now. And they're waiting to hear from you. And you have only 1 minute. 1 minute to share the most important lesson you've learnt. What would be your message to them?
It is actually divided into two parts. One is that everybody can run and you should enjoy what you are doing and compete only with yourself and you will achieve everything.
You will achieve everything. You need to enjoy what you are doing, and I really enjoyed this conversation. Thank you so much for being on this show.
So nice. It is my privilege and pleasure.
Thank you guys for being here and listening. I hope you enjoyed today's episode, and if you did, make sure you leave a rating and review and share it with your family and friends. Till the next one, get fit, get inspired.